All right, guys, this is MajorPandemic.com, trying to keep you alive and sharing a failure of my own with you. So what we have here is my partially stripped everyday defensive gun. This is my normal home defense gun, a GP100, Ruger GP100, chambered in 357 Magnum. Also shoots 38 specials, should you choose. And a big tank of reliability, this thing I've had forever. And it has never failed me, ever. And I've literally never had a round not go off in this gun. So this has been sitting next to my nightstand for, since a tweak I made on this gun, about 2 weeks, 3 weeks maybe, since I fired it last. And that's what has scared me. So I went to the range today, and I pulled the trigger. And nothing happened. Pulled it again. Nothing happened. Two more rounds went off. And then the other two didn't go off. Ah, what happened? Well, a lot of competitive shooters will upgrade the springs for the hammer and the return spring and revolvers. And even some of the automatics, some of their other springs, different springs, to lighter versions. So what this does is improve the trigger pull. Makes a lighter trigger pull, a more controlled trigger pull, and improves accuracy. So that's what my goal was when I went to Midway USA and picked up a set of Wolf Shooters spring pack for the Ruger GP100, reducing power. It's actually what it says it does for $10.29. So in that pack you get three different springs for the hammer spring and two different trigger latch springs. It's basically a trigger return spring that can greatly reduce the power. And so what that does is by reducing the power, if you're it's too hard to pull and it can you start shaking and you lose sight picture and you get less accurate. I'm just trying to improve my accuracy. And so what I replaced the original stock 14-pound spring with was a 9-pound. And what I replaced the trigger spring with was an 8-pound. So I had a very, very light, wonderful trigger pull for this gun that really changed the feel of the gun drastically. Now, the problem was, obviously, it didn't fire. So what happened? Well, typically, on a really nicely fired round, you end up with a nice, solid, big, fat dent in the primer that hits the primer, and the primer explodes. It catches fire, all the powder, pushes the bullet through pressure, down the barrel, and away we go, right? And what happened today is I got some light primer strikes because, obviously, we didn't have that 14-pound monolith of a spring banging against this primer, and this thing barely went off. In fact, this one has a dent in it, a very light, ballpoint-like pen dent, and it did not go off. Bad. So what we really need to do at that point is, even though a lot of the experts online said a 9-pound trigger would be fine for a gun, they refer to the percentage of a 100% gun, which is typically referred to as your defense weapon. I want this one to always be a 100% gun, regardless of how uncomfortable it may be to shoot on occasion. You always want your defensive gun to be 100%. And so I upgraded this back up to the strongest Wolf spring upgrade kit that's available, which is a 12-pound. According to what I've read online, this should do the trick. You're upgrading, you know, 3 pounds, and that should drastically assure that you're getting good, consistent hammer strikes on even some stubborn primers, and assure that you've got 100% reliability in your gun. But the big thing I want to point out is If you do make upgrades to your gun, make sure it is not your primary defense weapon in the interim period between the upgrades are installed and you have time to shoot. Don't make any assumptions that any of those upgrades are going to work. That was a really stupid thing on my part that I did, and I just wanted to share that with you. You should always make sure that if you do an upgrade on a firearm, that the very next day, at the very least, you go in and you shoot that at an indoor range and put at least 50 rounds through it to ensure you have durability and reliability of any upgrade parts you do. So that's very, very important. Just trying to keep you guys alive. Test your weapon after you make any upgrades and make sure your sights are good, you're zeroed in, you have good reliability of the weapon with at least 50 rounds, and no problems, no jams, no issues. Otherwise, go back to the stock factory setup and utilize that. Thanks a lot. Have a great day. Trying to keep you guys alive.